Hey guys, today we're going over installing and working with OpenShot Video Editor on Linux. This is a simple video editor that's similar to Windows Movie Maker. It doesn't have too many complex editing features, but it's really easy to use. So the first thing we'll do is get OpenShot installed. We'll add the repository and install the program. Type the following lines into the terminal. We'll also have these lines available in the video description. The entire installation for this program took us about 15 minutes on our computer, but most of that time was due to slow download speeds. Now that it's installed, we can go to the launcher and open the program. If it doesn't come up, just type in OpenShot. So first we'll do a little tour. The first box is where all the project files you import will be stored. After they're imported, you just drag and drop them onto the timeline. Then there's the transitions menu. These seem to work properly between clips, but don't work right if you're trying to fade in from darkness. We'll come back to this later on. As you can see, there's quite a few effects. Not all of them are completely useful. There's a lot that would honestly just decrease the quality of the video. We'll be sticking to the simple transitions, so we'll switch to the common mode by clicking the button at the top. Now we can look at the video effects. This program looks like it only comes with a few video effects. If we had to do any audio editing though, we'd probably just recommend using Audacity since it's simple to use. So we just have a few general effects here. As far as usefulness, the brightness and contrast are probably the best. The program does support the use of a green screen, but we wouldn't recommend this on such a simple video editor. So to get started, we'll import the files. The import button is in the file menu at the top. We've got a few stock videos in our downloads folder that we'll use for this example. Now that we've got the files imported, we'll drag and drop them onto the timeline. As far as order for the timeline, the videos that you place on the higher track number will be shown first. Therefore, a video on track 4 will cover up any overlapping videos on the lower tracks. Now we'll just drag in and trim these tracks. We'll want them to overlap a bit and experiment with the fades. Another useful feature is the title menu. We're just going to add a simple title to our video, but there are also a few animated titles that are worth taking a look at. So we'll make a sample title. We're changing the color of the background and the font. Since we've changed the background, it won't be transparent anymore in the final video. When the title is finished, OpenShot saves it as a scalable vector graphics file. Then it opens it in our project file so we can drag and drop it wherever we want on the timeline. Another feature you'll need to know about are the timeline options. If we click and drag on this bar, we can scale the timeline. There's also a little triangle that can insert markers at various points on the timeline, and there's buttons to jump between them. The last thing we want to do is organize the timeline. We'll right-click on the tracks and delete them. Then we can rename the tracks we want to keep. Finally, we just need to export the video. We've been working with 1080p 30fps video, and those are the same settings as our project. We'll export as an MP4 since these files work well with other programs, and we can upload the video to YouTube. The whole export process for this program can take a while. It's not quite as efficient as some of the higher-end video editing programs, so we'll just skip to the end of rendering and play back the video file we created. So now we can play the video back. As we can see, the transition for the title didn't work properly. The good news is that the video retained a fairly decent quality after re-rendering, so we can safely say that OpenShot is a pretty good solution to edit video for free. Thanks for watching this video on OpenShot Video Editor for Linux. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. You can also check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and our website, all of which are linked in the video description.